jeopardy and that spirit of grief. I'm talking about that spirit of grief that grabs on and it holds on year after year after year after year after year. I'm talking to you in Jesus' name, and we command you to loose the people right now in Jesus' name. We're thinking about your grandmother or your grandfather or that sister or that daughter or whatever it may be. We command that grief to be normal processing in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, for your glory, Father God. And there's somebody out there that are having a challenge in their body right now. They got a report of the cancer. That's a name that's got to bow at the name of Jesus. So why don't you just pray for that right there in Jesus' name, Father God. Just bow your head wherever you are. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Father.
Whatever that person is, whatever sickness they have, Father, we bind it in the name of Jesus. Whatever it is, Lord, we bind it.
Yes, yes, yes.
Father, we bind that cancer, Father. It has no place on that body. In the name of Jesus, Lord. Loose it.
In Jesus' name. And I can hear the Spirit of the Lord saying one of the problems is they hold in unforgiveness.
Yes.
Unforgiveness will block your blessing. And I hear you over there in radio land on the other side of this camera that you saying, you know, but you don't know what they did. Well, it don't matter what they did. See, it's a choice to forgive. It ain't about a feeling. Because if you open your Bibles and read in Matthew, the Lord's Prayer, you know, the Lord is my, our Father which art in heaven. And then he says down there in 13, 14, 15, if you don't forgive, he won't forgive you. So is there anybody or anything worth not having forgiveness?
No, nothing.
Nothing. I can't think of anything.
Many people have hurt me, but I have no...
You can't carry it.
No, I can't carry it.
You can't carry it because he won't forgive you. Yeah. He said, if you got to go leave your gift at the altar and go fix it and then come back.
Come back.
Amen. So right now, if you're dealing with unforgiveness out there,
Let it go now
in Jesus' name, you know, I know that tears are going to come.
Yeah.
The pain is there.
Yes.
And you know, you just don't know, but it's a choice. If you're willing to choose and you're letting yourself out of a cage, you're letting yourself out of bondage right now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we want to pray with you. That's right, you need to get on your knees right now. So you got to go back to theology in the name of Jesus and bow your head right now. And yeah, that's okay. Yes, go into that yesterday. And some of the people that maybe ever went on and to glory or went to hell or wherever they went, they may not even be on this earth right now. You got to forgive them. You got to let that thing go. So right now, Father, we hold up those people before you, Lord God, that have all that unforgiveness. And right now, Father, as they bow their heads and the tears are coming, they're choosing. Say it out loud. Say it out loud. Repeat it. I choose to forgive. Fill in the blank. Fill in the blank. Come on. Say it out your mouth. Say it out of your mouth. Say it out your mouth. By faith. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. That spirit of being abandoned and left with the children. Yeah. All that hurt and backstabbing. Let it go in Jesus' name. And now you just start blessing your enemies. Say, I choose to bless them and release them in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, praise the Lord. That's what we're talking about. You know, you're out there and, you know, God, he's just awesome and powerful God in Jesus' name. So again, I just want to thank you, woman of God. Tell me a little bit what you're doing in your ministry nowadays.
Well,
what's going on with you?
God's faith enhanced ministry.
All right.
We are working. We are growing. We are starting. Actually, we're going to start here pretty soon.
Praise the Lord.
Come back here.
Amen.
So we just asked the radio audience
praise
and the people
Jesus.
Here to keep our ministry lifted.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
God tells us to pray for one another.
Whatever we are doing, pray for one another.
Love one another.
Yes.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten
Son.
And so we love one another. Whatever we are doing, it will succeed.
Amen. So ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to S.O.V. and I'm Dr. Vicki Lee. And today is the day that the Lord has made. We're located in the beautiful city of Norwalk, California at 12110 East Firestone Boulevard. Right now, we're going to come to you right now with another awesome song by my friend John Gibson. Be blessed. Sit back and relax. Enjoy the gift of John Gibson.
this song that I'm going to sing right now is a song that I wrote a long time ago. And sometimes when we want to hold on to things and God wants us to let it go, sometimes we hold on even tighter.
Yes, yes.
And then when we finally let go, we find out that God was just trying to get us to let it go so that he could give us something even better.
Amen.
And then sometimes when we get that thing, that new thing, we're completely blown away and wonder why we held on to that old thing so long.
You give me